All right, thank you for coming in. Some are still coming in.
Am I good to start? You think we're all here?
Okay, you're live, Ms. Crouchy.
I borrowed that from Mrs. Jones. What a great way to get you quiet. Thank you, first grade. Thank you, kindergarten. And thank you, parents, for being here. I know some of you have to get back to work, so we very much want to start on time. Welcome to Rock Prairie. And welcome to the fourth grade music program we call All American. Welcome to November, even though I know it doesn't feel like it. But November is full of opportunities to celebrate our country, and that's what our fourth graders are doing today. So I hope you will enjoy their presentation and what they've done. And we're going to get started.
Thank you. Thank you, be seated. What could be more American than the Stars and Stripes? John Philip Sousa was the leader of the Marine Band from 1880 to 1896. In his lifetime, he wrote 136 marches. One stood out among the rest. He wrote his most famous march, Stars and Stripes Forever, in 1896. It is our national march, and in music class, we use this piece of music to solidify our understanding of whole notes, half notes, quarter notes, and eighth notes. Just watch. Thank you.
On the eve of the presidential election, we discussed the importance of knowing the history of this office. If you don't know which president served two non-back-to-back terms, then a presidential song will teach you.
The father of our country, George Washington, was one. Two was John Adams and Thomas Jefferson. Then was James Madison and also Dick Monroe. And John Quincy Adams was number six, you know.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents.
Andrew Jackson was the seventh in line. Then Martin Van Buren followed Annie's time. William Henry Harrison was next at number nine. John Tyler James Pope of State for two and five.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents.
Zachary Taylor Miller, Fillmore Franklin Pierce, and Jenny Jordan Left, things are getting pretty fierce. Abraham Lincoln went to war so we could be one nation living in peace and liberty.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents.
Andrew Johnson was the boss in those days. Then Ulysses S. Grant and Arthur Coney Hayes. James A. Garfield was the 20th Duke. And Chester A. Arthur showed his attitude.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents.
Grover Cleveland was the president then. Then Benjamin Harrison and Grover went again. William McKinley demonstrated his skill. Then Theodore Roosevelt charged up the hill.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents. The next in line was William Howard Taft. Then Woodrow Wilson got to try his craft. Lawrence G. Martin, Calvin Coolidge, Harvard Hoover. All of them presidential shakers and movers.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents. Franklin D. Roosevelt, a truly great man, and Harry S. Truman took the mantle of command. Dwight D. Eisenhower, followed close behind, and John F. Kennedy, whose death was underlined.
These are the presidents, mighty, mighty presidents.
Thank you. George W. Bush was number 43. Then Barack Obama made U.S. history. Say, can you see that all these men were bright? These are the presidents. All right.
Did you know Yankee Doodle was not actually a real person? It was a tune Brit the British sang to make fun of a colonist right before the Revolutionary War. The funny thing is, the colonists turned it into a war hymn. Mind the Music and the Step In with the Girls Be Handy simply meant learn how to dance. We have some fourth graders that have learned how to play. They make Yankee Doodle fun.
In 1895, Catherine Lee Bates was a young woman who had traveled to Colorado. When she reached the summit of Pike's Peak, the beauty stunned her. She wrote a poem that started out, "Oh, beautiful for spacious skies." Her poem later became one of our most loved patriotic songs, "America the Beautiful."
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies. Waves of pain, for purple mountains, majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee. And from my good with rather than from sea to shining sea.
I
guys for being such a good audience. I hope you enjoyed the show.
Let's give these fourth graders one more huge round of applause. Oh, Boys and Girls, you made me such a proud principal this morning and a proud, proud American. There is someone here we need to give an even bigger round of applause to, and that is our amazing music teacher, Mrs. Bratcher. She is amazing, and we thank her team staff and Nurse Benedict, who helped so much put this program on as well. So parents, thank you so much for joining us this morning. And those of you online who are joining us, I know you're there because I can see how many of you are watching. Thank you also for joining us. You know, this is an interesting time in our nation, but moments like this are what make us know that we live in the greatest place on earth. And so we have an excellent future ahead, and you guys, who do you think? Will one of you maybe be president one day? Yeah. Who wants to be president one day? Oh, I'm so excited. I want a Rockford Wrangler to be president one day, too. All right, hands down. Thank you all so much for coming. And fourth grade, one more time, you did amazing. Give yourselves a round of applause. Awesome. Awesome. Okay, that concludes our program. We hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day.
Fourth grade, Tilden Abrams.